Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you how you can create array of static and dynamic objects in C++. Before starting, you can note my information. You can connect with me by following these details. You can download my app Tachymys that is available on Google Play. You can search my channel on YouTube by typing my name on YouTube search bar. My channel will be available there. You can subscribe my channel if you want to follow my programming related videos. In this channel, various programming language related videos and playlists are available. You can follow this video if you want to learn programming. Now coming on to the topic, you can see a comment, array of static versus dynamic objects in C++ is written here. For that purpose, I have included a header file iostream. Then namespace std is used. Name of class is student. It has two attributes, roll number and name. Then read function is implemented. It will display enter roll number message on console. Then roll number will be stored inside RNO variable. Then enter name message will be displayed on console. Then name will be stored inside name variable. After completion of read function, print is implemented. It will display roll number and name on console that user has entered. After termination of class using this semicolon, main function is implemented. Here you can see array of static object is created. Name of array is S and its size is 3. So this is static objects array because its size cannot be modified at execution time. So for reading, loop is repeated 3 times. It is calling read function through S of I, and then print function is called inside loop. This loop is repeating again 3 times, and print function is called through S of I. So this is array of static object creation. Now first time executing this code, you can see it is asking for roll number. So I am entering 1. Then name of student, it is again asking for roll number. I am entering 2. And name of student, it is asking again for roll number. I am entering 3. And name of student, I have entered 3 students detail. You can see it is showing all the details on console. So this is static objects array. Now I am going to convert it into dynamic array. So first I am declaring a pointer p. Then an integer variable n. Then I am showing a message enter size, or you can say enter number of objects, how many number of objects you want to create. I am receiving that value inside n variable. Now with the help of new, I am going to allocate memory. So here array of dynamic objects is created. With the help of this statement, p equals to new student n. So n will be provided by the user. So at this time, at compilation time, we cannot predict how much amount of memory will be allocated. It will be decided at runtime. So that's why it is known as array of dynamic object. After that, loop will repeat n times at the time of reading and printing. So friends, this is implementation of array of dynamic objects. I hope you have understood the difference between static and dynamic object creation, or dynamic array of objects creation. In static array creation, size was fixed, but in case of dynamic, size is not fixed. It is provided by the user at execution time. Now I am executing this code. Sorry, here I have to use p of I instead of s, because this time pointer is p. In static array, name of array was s. It is executing properly. It is asking for number of objects, so I am entering 4. So this time it will receive information of 4 students. So I am entering first student details. Now it is asking for second, then third student detail, and then fourth student details. You can see the output. First, second, third and fourth, all four students details are displayed on console. So friends, this way you can create array of static objects as well as array of dynamic objects. The difference is, in case of static object, memory is allocated at compilation time, so you have to fix the amount of memory that you want to allocate. But in case of dynamic objects or array of dynamic objects, memory is allocated at runtime, so you can receive how much amount of memory will be allocated at runtime by the user. So dynamic object creation is better as compared to static object creation, and in both the cases implementation of class is same whether you are creating static object or you are creating dynamic objects. If you want to watch more programming related videos, you can search my channel on YouTube by typing my name on search bar. Here various programming related videos and YouTube playlists are available. Thank you for watching this video.